Hello everyone, welcome back to CSEC English with Ms. Keen. In today's video, we will be looking at reflection number 3. If you want to find out how to write this reflection, then do keep on watching. Today's word of encouragement says, work hard, dream big, never give up. Everything you don't know is something you can learn. So if you fail, continue to try and try again until you are successful. What should you include in reflection 3? Reflection 3 speaks to how the SBA process helped you to become a better person. It is recommended that you do this reflection after you have completed the entire SBA so as to capture how the entire process has impacted you in a positive manner. How should you write reflection 3? There is no set format for writing this reflection, but your information should flow logically and cohesively. You can focus on the following aspects. What have you learned from your research on the topic? So, in a paragraph, say what you have learned from your research. For example, if your individual topic is how dancehall music sexualizes young girls, then you can briefly state what you have learned from doing the topic. If you have garnered some new knowledge, then this is where you will state it. Maybe your initial thought before doing the research was that dancehall music does not sexualize young girls. But after extensive research, you realize that your assumption is flawed. In the next paragraph, you can focus on the language skills that you have developed. So, what are some of the language skills that have been developed? Since you are doing an English research, you will develop some amount of language skills. In your plan of investigation, you stated that you will develop 3 skills. So you can briefly speak on how these skills were enhanced, as well as other skills that would have been developed incidentally. So the last thing that you can focus on is the interpersonal skills that you have developed during the process of doing the SBA. Interpersonal skills are the skills required to effectively communicate, interact, and work with individuals in groups. When working with any group or team, especially when you have a common goal, there are certain social or interpersonal skills that will be developed. Having good interpersonal skills is key when you are working in a group. The ability to work together in a team is extremely valuable in obtaining the best possible marks for the SBA. Some of the skills that can be amplified when you are working with the group are flexibility, tolerance, conflict management, receptiveness to feedback or criticisms, good work ethics, consistency, time management or the ability to meet your deadlines, as well as the ability to communicate effectively. Like your other reflections, this entry should be well written in paragraphs. Here is a sample paragraph focusing on interpersonal skills. I have developed interpersonal skills such as time management, team building, and a positive approach to criticisms. These skills have certainly helped me to become a better person. Whenever I had any misconceptions, I would consult my teacher, Ms. Keen, for guidance on the completion of any given task. Thanks to this assessment, I have gained emotional intelligence to work with persons who have a different mindset, and as a result, I had to try to make things work. In this case, I have acquired more knowledge about how to work with others. Also, I am more equipped to handle difficult situations promptly when working with persons in a group who all have different perspectives. I hope that this video will help you in writing your reflection. Remember, everything you don't know is something you can learn. Please view the rubric for further guidance.